Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Buffalo, New York, near beautiful Niagara Falls, the scene for this college football matchup. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Takes it right side for a good game. Davis comes away with around 5 yards on that option keeper. And a quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
And he's tackled at the 45.
Gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
Throws it away. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. Brought down at the 29-yard line. The Owls have a new head man. New theories, new hopes, new dreams. Will there be new wins? We'll find out. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Now he's scrambling. They'll bring him down right around the 32-yard line. It to the 44.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Tackled after decent pickup.
Game of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Gets out to around the 28.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Check tight right. Pull out there. Check the outs up there.
Go down. Mike 56. Mike.
Makes it out to about the 19.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
A quarterback in the gun. With 5 receivers. There he goes. And they make the stop at the 11. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
From the 11-yard line, first down. Knocked out of bounds at the 7.
Gaining 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Tackled at the 11-yard line. That took a little too long to develop.
Yeah, the offense was trying to get the pass rush going upfield, but the defense did a nice job of sniffing out the draw play and hitting them in the backfield.
Third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 11-yard line. Tackle made at about the 3-yard line.
It was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
He's taken down at the 1.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it first and goal.
And the goal line defense digging in here. Touchdown, Rice! He splits the uprights with the extra point. So an 11-play, 71-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Owls are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. And he's going to be sacked.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 11.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
Now he tries to buy some time. Got the corner. He's tackled in the open field. From their own 41-yard line. Second down. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Scrambling around. Tackle at the 44.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up third and 6.
Receiver screen and complete.
Williams was the intended receiver on the play.
The Bulls saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Strong will be the return man. And he can't hang on to the ball. Calls for the fair catch. Rice has got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. So at the end of one, the Owls lead 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2.
Four down, four down. Hey, Mike 51, Mike 51.
Great run here, and he's got nowhere to go.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Gets out to about the 22-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it third and 9.
Man left. Go down. Mike 51.
Red. Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch. And down he goes around the 14-yard line. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. The kick is up, and it's good. Buffalo, the kick. Gathered in at the six. Tackle at the 36. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Rice is up by four. He's at midfield. Brought down around the 47-yard line.
First down.
Chucks it downfield. Can't haul it in.
The pass ball is incomplete. Bradshaw is the intended receiver.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down.
Mike 56.
Throws middle to the tight end, and he's tackled at the 38-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Tackles him hard at the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Right, right. Mike 56.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. Brought down in the open field.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 6.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Gain of 8 yards. First down.
I got two. Mike 56. Check.
With the pass, incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Rice is up four. Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down to the 7-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That'll make it third and 1.
Watch two.
All day, just like that.
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Yeah,
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Gets to around the 42.
They did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense is able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
Buffalo is going to use their first time out of the half here. About 2 minutes before halftime. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
He has one job on passing situations, get to the quarterback, and he did that job very, very well on that play.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Stevens is the punter. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. Rice's team, when you look at him, I think they got to be happy with how versatile they can be, because they do have a star that is not having a star-type game right now, and yet they got the lead here, and we're almost at halftime.
Yeah, I think they've really shown their versatility as an offense. To think that we would be sitting here close to this first half being over, and to see that their go-to wide receiver is not putting up these big numbers, and yet they still have the lead, just tells you a lot about their coaching, the in-game adjustments, and the way the rest of the teammates of this receiver stepped up.
Passes to the back, incomplete.
Boy, that was a rocket. If the receiver didn't come down with it, the quarterback made sure nobody else was going to come down with it either.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he hits him hard at the 45-yard line. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one.
When he made the decision to return the ball, I'm sure he thought there was going to be some room to run. But boy, did it vanish in a hurry. Still, he got something out of it.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Oh, gains about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and six.
Second and six. Ball on their own 30. So at the end of the half, Rice leads it 14-3. Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He'll return it from the six. He makes it to the 28-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Gets out to around the 38.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Slings it. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. Good tackle. He was the last line of defense.
Knox makes a tackle at the 17-yard line. First down.
The 10. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Owls. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Top 25 action on the way. And for Arkansas, they're in danger of losing two straight. The Tigers have the edge, 17-14.
Thanks, Reese. 21-3, our score here. Ford has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Owls continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Quick throw, and they make the stop at the 28. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
He's tackled at the 27.
Loss of one on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
Check four. Kill. Check.
Feeling the pressure, and he fumbles the football. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. Here's the halfback on the screen. And he's level at the 19-yard line.
Jacobson's under tackle at the 19-yard line. That'll make it fourth and 10.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
Bevo's starting to snort. The horns ready to go in Austin. The Buckeyes deliver the perfect connection and a touchdown. Ohio State leads it 7-3.
It's 24-3 in this one. Rice ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, at the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 41-yard line. The Bulls have just gone ice cold on offense. They can't seem to get anything going.
And right now, they just have to forget the score, forget the clock, just go out there and try to get a first down, try to hope to build a little bit more confidence and continuity on this offense.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Runs right for a nice gain. For a loss.
He wasn't decisive at all in that option, and once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
From their own 44-yard line, it's third down. Tackle around the 39-yard line.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
Moore, back to return it. It's away, short punt. He's tackled at the 43. The quarterback leads his squad back out. They got three on their last possession. Hands off up the middle and stuffed. At the 40, to the 20, the 10, touchdown!
You love to have a home run threat like him in the backfield. Every time he touches the ball, he's capable of tearing one off like that.
And he converts the extra point. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. Whoa, he just took a licking. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. He's scrambling. Tackle made at the 32. Here's the call from the referee.
Delay of game, offense.
Looked like they might have been a little bit late getting the play in, and it results in a delay of game. So the penalty will make it first and 15. He scrambled. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Watch the run, watch the run. Mike 51,
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. Taken down at the 23. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
And it looks like they're going to run away with this one as we head into the fourth quarter. The Owls with a huge lead. Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. Stevens is waiting for the snap. Moore fields it at the 42. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Rice up by a big margin. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down the 39-yard line.
Makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 39.
Reset, tight right.
They come out on an empty backfield. He's on the run. He's at the 30, and he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
That's good.
Hey, watch the slant. Mike 56.
Ready. Cut hard. 95.
Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Second and 9. Ball on the 26-yard line. Scrambling inside the 10. He's taken down at the 9-yard line. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
Second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Nice run, and he's brought down. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Mike 56.
Here we go, D. Here we go. It's just me and you.
They get in. Touchdown. 3 rushing touchdowns on the ground today for this young man.
If I were the head coach of this football team, I would give him the ball at least 30 times a game.
And he adds the extra point. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
The Longhorns sitting in the top 5 and hoping to move up. We've been watching this thing all day long. The Longhorns have the perfect connection and a touchdown. The Longhorns have the lead, 27-21.
Well, there's some talk this week that we might see some upsets this week. I don't think you could ever expect that to happen, though. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 20-yard line. Rice is just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
Well, this defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. And they've got a nice lead here in the fourth quarter.
And it'll be interesting to see how much fight this team has left in them. This has been a brutal game. Just under 2 to go in the game. He's got an opening.
Job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. He's hit and taken down. In the shotgun and 5 wide out. It in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That makes it 1st and 10.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on their own 49. Slings it out there incomplete. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws. He's improved. But as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
Quick strike to the back, and he drops it. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. Nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but it's a blowout and has been for most of the game. I think it's time for everybody to go home.
That'll make it 4th and 10.
Delta!
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Rice has proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere.
With the safeties coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. He makes it to the 35-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That makes it 37.
Strong performance today. I think nationally, Kirk, it's going to take a hit as him being a superstar. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it could hurt him, but at the same time, the team won. He didn't have a great game, but the fact that his team was able to kind of rally and still come up with a win, I still think it helped his cause as far as some of the national recognition.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.